sometimes expresses itself in sacrifice. I thought maybe if she loved him, she'd let him go.
But she, or it, is inhuman, Captain. You cannot expect her to react like a human.
I tried.
It's useless, I know.
Zephram Cochrane.
Bones? I don't understand it. She's not sick at all.
We understand.
It's her.
What?
Don't you understand? It's a companion.
Bones? He's perfectly healthy. Heart like a hammer. Respiration normal. Blood pressure normal. This is medically impossible.
We are here.
We?
Both of us. Those you knew as the Commissioner and the Companion. We are both here.
Companion, you do not have the power to create life.
That is for the Maker of all things.
But Commissioner Hedford was dying.
That part of us was too weak to hold on. In a moment, there would have been no continuing. Now we're together.
Then you are both here, in the one body.
We are one. Zephram. We frighten you. We've never frightened you before. Bitter thing. Oh, Zephram, it's so sad. How do you bear it, this loneliness?
Spock, check out the shuttlecraft. Engine, communications, everything.
That will not be necessary, Captain. Your vehicle will operate as before. So will the communications device.
You're letting us go?
Nothing now to stop you. You said we would not know love because we were not human. Now we are human. We will know the change of the days. We will know death. But to touch the hand of the man, nothing is as important.
You're very beautiful.
Part of me understands, part does not. But it pleases me.
I could explain many things.
Oh, let me walk, Zephram. Let me feel the earth against my feet. Let me feel the warmth of the sun on my face. You beside me, but let me feel these things.
Go ahead, Gagarin. We have a few things to do.
Mr. Scott, it's the captain.